This is one of those things I've seen in my nightmares.
But he saw it in real life. A creepy-looking lizard is taking over a Cape Coral backyard. And it's not just one lizard. It's a whole family.
This thing is called a monster lizard. It's an invasive species that could cause big problems for our local ecosystem. So let's get you more on these things. Our Gage Golding in Southwest Cape Coral tonight, where crews are working to capture the creature. Gage.
While they're gliding through the grass, NIO monitors look like just about any other lizard, but they are far from it. They're invasive to our region, they're damaging to our ecosystem, and they're taking over a Cape Coral backyard.
Did you see it? It looks like a cross between a snake, an alligator, and a lizard.
This thing, it looks nasty.
Jason Durkovics took this video of a NIO monitor over the weekend. His dog spotted the massive reptile that went crazy.
It was in a panic mode or it was in an attack mode. Either one left me feeling uncomfortable.
It jumped up the wall before darting towards him and his dogs.
I lost my breath in that moment, to be honest.
He heard about NIO monitors when he moved to the Cape about 2 years ago, but little did he know, these aren't your average lizards.
These are considered monster lizards.
Ella Gedwar is a grad student at the Water School at FGCU. She studied animals all around the world, and of all places in the world, these NIO monitors are invasive, and their population is growing in three parts of Florida, one of which is right here in Cape Coral.
Cape Coral is actually the biggest population of NIO monitors in Florida.
Now the story is coming full circle for Jason. Just a little after spotting this six-footer, he found this, a baby NIO monitor on his dock.
But this thing was not cute by any stretch of the imagination.
It's a sure sign that these monster lizards that were likely pets let loose in the 80s or 90s are flourishing in the Cape. That's bad news for us and the environment.
They'll eat things that are as small as a squirrel, but they can also probably take down a small dog or a cat.
So what should you do if you spot a NIO monitor? Ella says, stay back.
Although their bite would be harmless to you, it would really, really hurt.
You should also call the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission. They can set up a trap and humanely euthanize them. That's exactly what Jason's doing.
I do hope that they grab this thing and get it out of here as quick as possible.
Reporting in Cape Coral, Gage Golding, ABC 7.